I don't have control. So I just needed to acknowledge your presence. We thank you for everything that you're going to do in this tea party. We thank you for every word that's going to be spoken. We thank you for persons who've traveled near and far to come pour into Donna Bruce Unlimited. And right now, we just acknowledge your presence here. So continue to move and guide and lead how you want to lead. And you just keep showing me, God. I am not in control of anything. So have your way, God. I surrender to you again on a daily basis, God, over and over and over again. I just keep turning it over to you. So make the connections that need to be made and move by your spirit and pour into us. We ask all these things in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, I'm turning it over to Miss Jones. Yeah. The tea on the tea party.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Good afternoon. I am Joyous Jones. And I have been doing this for a few years. Everybody looks so beautiful. It's beautiful. Thank you so much for having me. I just wanted to let people know some of the do's and don'ts of a tea party. A lot of times we've been had a chance to be afforded to go to Barbizon School. I don't think they make schools for ladies anymore. They don't teach young ladies how to be young ladies. Home economics is not a part of the curriculum. How to set a table is not a part of the curriculum. But I'm here to tell you, if we go back to the basics of teaching our young ladies to be young ladies, they won't get caught up in crimes and different things that will offset them. How many of you know, if you look, the young ladies now are just as thugs. They are thugged out. They have guns and they're running around the streets of Baltimore, Philadelphia. I was in Philadelphia last night. Just like the men are. They're standing out there selling drugs just like the guys are. But I have a commission by God to tell women what their purpose is. We have a purpose. And if you know your purpose, then you have your power. There's authority and power in knowing your purpose. The tea party started many, many years ago in the 1800s. And it has filtered down into America by, it was the Duchess of Bedford. She was new from England. And she didn't know anyone, and she wanted to meet people, and she wanted, her husband would go out, and traditionally there were not three meals a day, there were two meals a day, and they would have breakfast, and then in between they would not eat, and they would be starving, and she would get headaches, and she would have hunger pains, and so she started hosting tea parties. And she would have the elite come over and share tea. A lot of people think that high tea and low tea has to do with the time. It really does not have to do with the time. It has to do where you are sitting at the table. And usually the high teas were in the evening because you were at the table sitting high with a tea plate at your breast. The low tea was in a dining room or in a den with the tea below your knees or at your knee level. So that made it a low tea, and then the regular tables made it a high tea. One of the other things that have traditionally, some of the do's and don'ts that get us so confused for tea parties is how many people think that this is such a cute way of saying that I am being dainty and ladylike. Well, I'm here to tell you that that is considered rude. traditionally the elite and the aristocrats considered low-class people to hold their pinky out. So to actually hold the teacup, you would take your index finger, your thumb, but make sure that the second finger and the other fingers were underneath the teacup, like that. So you would always hold your teacup in this manner. Never, ever, ever, if you're seated, lift your saucer up. Only if you are standing and your guest is standing, the hostess is standing, do you hold your teacup. And you would hold your teacups kind of hard with this. Hold your teacup like this when you're talking. If you're speaking to someone and you're holding your teacup and you're walking around and you're just socializing, you would never, ever take your eyes off of that one and always, I think I said it backwards, you take your eyes off and always look down, lifting your cup up, holding your teacup, so that you will watch and your eyes should go down with your cup so that you won't spill your tea on your shirt and on your clothes. Never, ever, and that was considered rude, or that was considered a poofah. So in order to do that, you would always, and it's such a ladylike thing, and it takes a moment to let someone know, I am sipping my tea. So you would lower your eyes to your teacup, pause, never talk while you're sipping your teacup, and then you would place your tea back on your saucer. Never, ever would you lift it up while you're seated down at the table. Say you wanted to stir. It would be very, very considered rude if you would take your teacup. You should never hear this sound. The only time you would hear this sound was when a hostess was trying to get the attention of the crowd. So this means that I am trying to get attention. So anybody that would stir and make noise, someone would look at you and indicate to you that that was a poofah, because you only did it to get attention. So you would never, they would never hear your, if you took the tip of your spoon and you stirred gently and firmly and keeping your spoon as straight up and down and going around in a circle, you would never ever hear it make that noise. They should never hear that noise. Never, ever, ever would you be caught sipping your tea with your spoon. That was considered unladylike. You would always and never, ever, ever leave the spoon in the cup before you sipped your tea. What that did was you would make those spills, and if you were standing and walking and talking with your cup, you would take your spoon out once you have stirred it and place it on the saucer in front of you, always to the right if you're right-handed, and most people are right-handed generally, and always like that. Never, ever leave the spoon inside of the teacup. It is so unladylike. So I just like to do that. Now, I have some things that let people know. What is the tea used for? There are some traditional things that tea is used for, and it is used for socializing. What would happen in the 1800s, there were no cell phones. There were no
tell their husband's business. They would talk about it. It was considered gossip sessions, but they would say, well, you know, my husband does this, and my husband does that. And the other one would say, and my husband does this, and my husband does that. So they would go home, and they would report back to their husbands during the day as to what their husband, what they had, who they met, and why they met them. It was considered networking. But they considered it gossip, but it was networking. It was an antiquated way of how we now socialize and do social media. And a scripture that comes to mind was, a husband will be known in the gate by her virtuous woman. Because she would go and she would promote her husband.
Wow.
That was the key to having the tea parties. And so as she drew, people came, and more people started picking up tea parties. And so it became a hit in the United States. And then it began to be a hit in the 1900s. And you would see that a servant would never, ever, 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 when you were sitting down, you have a napkin in front of you, just a little tea on the napkin. There is a scripture, and we've just passed Resurrection Sunday. And if you notice, if you go back and you read the story of Jesus being in the sepulchre, you will find that there was a folded napkin at the head of the sepulchre. It was neatly folded and placed there. On the side was Jesus' grave clothes. The folded napkin meant that you're not finished, that you have some more to do.
Wow.
You're not finished with your plate, so you're not, he wasn't finished. So whenever you get up from your table, make sure you take your napkin, leave it in your chair. That lets the waitress know or the hostess know that I'll be back. I'm not finished with my food.
Wow.
Just a little secret a lot of people don't know about the napkin. And if you have silk or cloth napkins, make sure you have a paper napkin. It is so rude to leave your lipstick or your makeup on the silk or the cloth napkins for your hostess to clean, because some of that stuff now don't come out. But that's one of the things about the napkin and the tea and the tea party. But I wanted to give some of the things that that tea is used for and utilized for. It's amazing to me. I get excited about it because it had so many different uses that I kind of chuckled. A repellent for mosquitoes.
Wow.
Dye for fabric. Household plants.
Wow.
Occasionally used brew tea bags instead of water to feed ferns and household plants. And it makes them richer and greener and brighter. Add to compost.
Wow.
Tenderize meat. Prevent dizziness.
What?
Drink tea for a variety of health reasons made older adults to realize that black tea could reduce dizziness.
Wow.
Cure the common cold. Japanese and Chinese traditions swear that a tea is tested, it's a tested remedy. And I remember when I would get sick and my mom would make me tea and honey. And that was the comfort food besides chicken noodle soup, but some hot tea to cure the tea. And it says it gets smarter. Caffeinated teas is proven effects on mental alertness. And a lot of people don't realize that tea has most teas, black teas, and green teas have more caffeine than coffee. Any coffee drinkers in the house?
Yes.
So when they tell you not so much coffee, just tell them that tea has more caffeine. Most teas have more caffeine, and you have to get the decaffeinated tea. But so I don't know if there's any questions or anything like that that anybody has on how to conduct the tea. And if you're standing, always keep your salsa with you. Never walk around with just a teacup by itself. Always have the salsa. If you're sitting down, never pick the salsa up. Pull it to you. And always, when you sip your tea, make sure you stop talking and look down to see where your tea is going. We want it in our mouths and not on our clothes. So that is the tea to the tea party. And I hope that I've done something or said something to help you. And it's important that we maintain tea parties, maintain ladiness. It is a good thing to go back to the basics. The next tea party, invite someone younger than you to come in and learn the skills of tea so they will understand what tea parties are all about.
Wow.
I hope I've said something to help everybody.
Thank you.
Absolutely.